Already know you're now tuned in to one of the hottest online publications that there is, Vocab magazine. And you know who I am. I'm your host, Mr. Vocab TV, Tali. Sitting to my right, we have our diamond for that fresh new into 2013 February issue of Vocab magazine. We have the lovely, lucky Luchiana, who is definitely gracing us with her presence for that diamond issue. So, you know, we definitely want to get into, you know, everything that you're working on. There's more to it than just the modeling. And we know that you're definitely positioning yourself to be successful coming in these coming years. But let's start off with the modeling thing. How long have you been modeling and what were your inspirations into getting into modeling?
Okay. Well, aspirations, I didn't have many when I was 17. My first music video, I was 17 years old. My family really didn't support the fact that I was modeling. It kind of just got brought to me. I was walking out of beauty school, I was 17 years old, and a good friend of mine, Waleek, he's a good friend of mine till this day. He stopped me in the middle of the street. He never knew me, and he said, "Oh, you gotta be a model." And I was like, "Get the hell out of here, I'm not a model." He was like, "Yes, but there's something about me he saw, you know," and I was very humbled by it. So he gave me an audition date. I went and I did the audition. It was, you know, for Joe Budden, Busta Rhymes, Fire video. That was my first music video. I was 17 years old. Yeah, I was very nervous. But after that, you know, I started developing a passion for it. And it just became a lot of fun.
It sounds kind of typical, a guy coming up to you saying you must be a model. And then turns out it was someone that actually got you casted for that big video. And, you know, a lot of people may know Lucky Luchiana for that video with Busta Rhymes and Joe Budden for Fire and things like that. So, you know, with your career and the way it's going in right now, you want to tell us some of the things you're working on now? I know you're in school, and that's kind of important. That's the thing that I want, a topic I want to touch about. Let's talk about being in school and what you're majoring and what you're trying to do with your career, you know, with the foundation of you being in school.
Okay, well, I know school, if I can relay any message to any girls out there, school is so important, and it's just very important to stick with whatever passion you have and just go for it. You know, school is so important in so many ways. I'm blessed to be able to do what I'm very passionate about. I'm very passionate in hair and makeup, and I do go to cosmetology school right now. Thank God, with good God's grace, I graduate next month, so, you know. Kudos to that. Girls, if you have any passion and have any aspirations in life, please, please stay in school. You know, that's one message I would always relay. Always relay. You know, because no one wants a pretty girl and nothing going on up there. That's so true.
Yeah, absolutely. That could be a turn off in a sense. Some of us are kind of shallow, you know. We don't care. We just want the good looks, right? I'm joking. Just a little bit, though. Just joking a little bit. But with you being in school and you having something to fall back on, you know, say for instance, not to say that that's what's going to happen, but say for instance, things don't go the way that you plan for it to go in the modeling industry and with everything else that you're working on. What's your fallback plan and what are you going to do?
Well, my fallback plan, it's not a fallback plan, but I've always have a couple of things like lined up. I'm doing acting classes every Wednesday. I do have a passion for acting. Hopefully one day, you know, I'll become a famous superstar, but that's a one in a gazillion chance. I put my money on staying in school. Definitely investing in a business that, you know, it's going to be very profitable for me and my family in the future. And with everything else, I just hope and chance and work hard, and hopefully one day it'll pay off. Please.
Well, she's trying to be modest right now. And this is actually segues into what I want to talk about she hopefully plans to be a big actress. We know there's some things in the works, and you know, I'll let you elaborate on it, but I just want to open the platform. Aside from modeling, what are some of the things that you are working on? Big screen wise.
I did get casted in a movie that we are working on. It's being shot in Brooklyn. It is a sequel to a movie that's already been out there. It's Bees in the Trap. It should be coming out within a couple months. My role in the movie is exciting because I'm going to be an assassin. So watch out. So, you know, I'm prepping for the role, and we're starting to shoot. And it's an exciting role for me, so I can't wait for it to come out. And you guys can see my kick-ass movie.
Yeah, well, we can't wait either. She's gonna be an assassin, so you know that's gonna be kind of big. And she's talking about maybe, ain't no maybe. I don't think it's a maybe in this right now. But
I'm definitely excited. You guys definitely stay in tune for that, and you guys are gonna love it, love it, love it, love it. Yeah, Bees in the Trap.
Well, we'll definitely be on the lookout for Bees in the Trap. I'm pretty sure that's something that everybody will be able to get their hands on. And we actually going to have some footage and things that I didn't. Matter of fact, I'm not going to give that up. Just tune in to Vocab Magazine, and you'll be able to get everything on Bees in the Trap pretty soon. But we also want to talk about that amazing shoot that you did with Mr. Kenny, Katie Stars. We always got to show love to Katie Stars because he does an amazing job with, you know, certain scenery shots and things of that. But he did, the two of you got together and y'all actually made magic for that diamond issue. Let's talk about how that shoot went, because we know Kenny is a little crazy, but he's good at what he does, though. So how was the shoot with you and Kenny?
Kenny is a photographer. I love Kenny. He's very blunt. He's very abrupt. He's hilarious. I'll cuss you on a heartbeat, but say he loves you the same time, same breath. But he, you know, there's something about his chemistry and his work with photography in the past. He knows what he's going for, and he's going to push you until, you know, he gets the shot out of you. And, you know, I definitely appreciate him for that. And I definitely, you know, appreciate him for his professionalism and, you know, his hard work. You know, he's very talented. And, yeah, if anyone that works with him, you know, has nothing but good things to say about him. And I can't wait to see these pictures. I know you guys have. So yeah, I'm excited to see them. I know, you know, like our like past shoots, they just come out, all our pictures come out really, really good. And it's all, I tip my hat down to Kenny. He's a great photographer.
Yeah, he's definitely about his job, and he's always on point. And the secrets is definitely there, because I honestly didn't know you didn't get to see any of the pictures, but all we can say is that they came out amazing. But don't take it personal, Kenny. You know we love you. You know Vocab love you to death. I know I called you a little crazy, but you know how you do, man. We all love you, Kenny, though. But, you know, everybody's going to want to know, you know, such a beautiful young lady. Everybody's going to want to know exactly where you come from, because, you know, she has a very, very, very strong face, a lot of good features and things like that. But looking at you, nobody could really tell exactly where you're from. You want to give them an idea of your origin and your background?
Yes. Well, my mom, her family hails from Puerto Rico, so all I can be Boricuas. And my father, he hails from Peru, but our grandmother was Chinese. So Shay Shay. So I am a mixture of a lot of things. I'm a mini mutt, or whatever you like to call it. I don't mind. I don't care. But it is what it is, and I'm passionate about what I am. I'm very happy and blessed of what my parents did. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Dad. I love you guys.
I think we all are mutts in one sense or another. They call us mutts mutations, but it be like that at times.
It's a positive thing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. But mutts are beautiful. Mutts are beautiful things.
I mean, you can't go wrong with that. You already see. But, you know, in the beginning, you know, where it started out, you know, with you deciding to model and things like that, who was some of your inspirations, like, as far as, like, you know, high-end fashion, even urban models and things like that, that kind of inspired you more to want to work harder to get into this field?
I have so many inspirations. I can definitely say Kamora Lee Simmons was one of my top idols. Just because she had a Asian background, and I could adapt with that. You know, growing up and being mixed, you know, you definitely get teased for what you are, especially in a community where it's a majority, gringos. I love my gringos. My parents are gringos. So, but you know, it's hard at times, but then you see someone that's very successful and beautiful, you know, you can kind of identify with that. And I always remember idolizing her and wanting to be her one day. And I think she's just an amazing, amazing person, strong, independent, beautiful, and she kicks ass. I love her. And she doesn't take shit from anybody. So yeah, that's someone I definitely inspired to be. Love my parents. I look up to both my parents. The parents that raised me upstate, they're both lesbians. You know, coming from a small, you know, community, you know, having parents, you know, that were both gay, you know, it was hard at times, but, you know, I admire them. They're independent and they're strong and they're very smart. And, you know, I hope one day that I could be as strong and as smart as they are. You know, I love them very much. So it's definitely a big inspiration.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, it's definitely like, you know, a big issue, you know, with the LGBT, you know, community. You know, we always show love because we are in the fashion and we know that's a big community, and that community definitely supports us. And, you know, for someone of your stature to, you know, be brought up in that household and things of that nature, you know, that's another topic for another discussion that we could have somewhere down the line. But, you know, it's good to see you doing the things that you're doing, and we definitely have to send a big shout out to your parents who did an amazing job raising you.
Love you guys. I love you guys. Miss you guys. Can't wait to see you guys. Please don't be mad at the pictures. They're all done in good taste.
Yes, all of them are good. Trust me, this is Vocab Magazine. We definitely make sure they're good, done in good taste. Of course, you know, you want to give some imagination for the eyes and for the mind to think about. But in all actuality, her shoe came out amazing. So it's nothing that you have to be ashamed of. So definitely, you know, moving forward, we want to know, you know, some of the plans, aside from the movie, some of the plans that you have for 2013.
So next month I plan to graduate, so I'm very, very thankful for that. You know, for God's grace, I graduate 28th next month. You guys are more than invited to come to my graduation. Pop a bottle.
You know, Vocab would definitely be there for that.
Yes. So I'm excited about that. And after graduation, I'm still continuing my acting classes. We have a play coming out in about 11 weeks. You guys are more than invited to come. Of course, Vocab is there to show love and support. So that'll be my first onstage performance in a while. So I'm very excited about that. So you guys, more than valuable to get your tickets. The 3 Vocab.
Right. Yeah, we're gonna have that posted on the homepage. So when the tickets for the play go on sale, believe you me, you will be able to get in tune with that.
Absolutely, absolutely. So besides that, just get established with an agency. A lot of agencies are looking at me, and I'm looking at them. So, you know, hopefully buckle down on one of them and just take my career to the next level. So, with all that being said, wish me luck. Wish me luck. Hope see you guys at the top. Top.
Well, I think with everything that you already put there and forward and the groundwork that you already laid, it's not about luck. It's just about win. In Vocab Magazine, beauty, swag, and fashion is our slogan, it's our language, and our lifestyle that we live by. When you hear the words beauty, swag, and fashion, what comes to mind?
Beauty, intelligence, absolutely. Fashion, get your swag up all day. All day. Got your swag right. You know what I'm talking about. And...
I gotta get my swag up. I appreciate the compliment. I'm trying to get my swag up.
Swag. That's me on swag. You wifey? That'd be gorgeous. That's some swag. Okay? You don't get a girl like that without swag.
Yeah, I heard her. She's actually manning the camera right now, too. Gotta definitely send a shout out to the wife back there, Judy.
Exactly. She's beautiful. Congratulations. Definitely.
Well, thank you. She probably can't hear you right now, but she'll see this interview.
Yeah, she's gorgeous. She knows it. Got a bad one. Got a bad. You're too funny. You guys are hilarious.
Yeah, we try to be. We try to make you comfortable. We appreciate it. We appreciate you being a part of this issue. So, you know, we definitely want to make you feel comfortable.
Yeah, and I appreciate being a part of it. You know, I've stepped out of Maryland for a while. You know, I was upstate Syracuse, no man's land. So now that I'm back, and I definitely try to like dive into as many things possible. You guys welcomed me with open arms, and I definitely appreciate it. Very thankful, Vocab, Mag. We'll forever be grateful to you guys.
Well, we're grateful to you, and we're glad that, you opened your arms to us to actually be a part of this. So let's talk about, you know, like your fashion sense and things like that when you're going out on your own leisure time. Who were some of the designers that you like to wear, or if not designers, what kind of style that you, you know, you put out there in the public just to, you know, represent yourself?
I love so many designers. I mean, what girl doesn't love a good pair of red bottoms? But, you know, but of course, you know, I definitely go for a funky, punk, rock kind of look, but very edgy, not too over the top. I like my skulls. Weird, strange, I know. I like my skulls. I love my pink. I love BB. Anything from Victoria's Secret, always being worn underneath clothes. Just, you know, just for you guys to know. But I love Vicky.
We love Vicky Secrets too. We love Vicky Secrets, always.
Yeah, who doesn't, right? Oh man, I love them. I love these women. Going there, you've been to the new one? Oh my God, the one downtown is amazing. Besides that, I love anything that, you know, is cutting edge, new, fresh. You know, if I can wear it down and I feel good and sexy in it, then I'll rock it. You know, if it has a nice label on it, you know, thumbs up. If it doesn't, I'm not going to be heartbroken over it. As long as I feel good in it and it's beautiful and it forms me well, then I'm going to rock it. Rock it hard. So, yeah, besides that, I can go on for days with labels, but it will be here forever, you know.
Well, I think it's a positive for Vocab. The longer we keep you here, the more viewers we're going to get. That's how I look at it.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Well, you know, you definitely have an intriguing story. You definitely have a long road ahead of you, and we definitely want to follow you in your progress going into the future. But for some of the individuals that's watching you, and, you know, the young ones, of course, that aspire to do the things that you're doing, you have any words of advice for them?
Yes. Keep your morals, you know, keep your self-respect, and just work hard. You know, it's all about the hard work. You can't expect for everything just to be handed to you on a silver platter. You gotta just, if you want something, you gotta go out there and get it. And, you know, don't take your first no as a rejection and give up. You just gotta keep hearing it and keep hearing it. You know, if one door closes, 100 more will open. Trust me, believe me. But a lot of doors close in my face. So just keep pushing. You know, eventually it'll pay off. Definitely.
So for some of the new fans and followers that you may get with our audiences in Vocab Magazine and Vocab TV, you want to open up the social platforms to where they could follow you on Instagram, Twitter, you know, even like your fan page if you have one on Facebook, or any websites that you have out there?
Yes, well, I just got into the internet scene. So what I am, one thing that I do have, I would love if you guys find me on Instagram. It is Lucky Luchiana. That Instagram, but it's Lucky Luchiana, and that's what trips people out, but they think it's the S to see. But Lucky Luchiana, please friend me. I'm new to it. You know, I have a lot of friends that I would love some more, so just hit me up. Definitely. Definitely.
Well, I know you're going to definitely get some new friends on that sense, but how about Facebook? You got a Facebook fan page or a website?
I have a funny story about Facebook. I had Facebook over 5,000 friends, and my ex went and deleted my account.
But you have 5,000 friends. He don't want to share you with the world.
Yeah, that's terrible, isn't it? But now I'm working on getting that back up. So when I get a new one, you guys will be the first to know. Definitely, definitely.
We definitely, what you do is just make that fan page. So all I got to do is go in there and like it. Any plans for making a website in the future?
Yes, absolutely. I'm definitely, I'm working with a couple web designers to make myself a fan base. So as soon as I get that going, it'll definitely have something to do with Lucky Luchiana and future reference to Google. So within a month or two, most likely 1 month.
I will give you that little bit of time. But we also want to say thank you for your time. Thank you for the efforts that you put into the shoot, for being our diamond. By far, one of the most fun that we had doing an interview with one of our diamonds. I mean, not taking anything away from any of the previous diamonds, but we enjoyed your time and things like that. So as always, I'm your host, Mr. Vocab TV, Talik. Lucky Luchiana, you have the links, you have the outlets. Make sure you connect with her. Look out for that movie, Bees in a Trap, coming to you soon. Beauty, swag, and fashion is our lifestyle. We only want to make it yours. What do you say about that?
Word.
Until next time, peace.